Welcome again, Woodside Farms. It's a beautiful spring day after a great rain, so we're really excited about the growth that's going to bring this week. But Woodside Farms is a 10-acre farm. We're nestled in Hanover County, really close to Route 1, so we're super accessible. And even though we're a 10-acre farm, right now we probably have less than an acre in vegetable production. So that means that we do just a lot of intensive planting, where we flip over beds pretty regularly to get fresh stuff coming in as consistently as possible. We also do a lot of companion planting, where different plants are planted close to each other and they provide one another with benefits. And intraplanting too, like radishes with cabbage, kohlrabi with spinach, cucumbers with kohlrabi. So that provides, it's a great way for us to sort of add variety to the vegetables we grow. It helps us with our timing, and it helps us on space, since we are trying to do things more intensively. So another thing I wanted to talk about is just that, you know, we're sort of in a spring fury right now, doing a lot of planting, whether it's transplanting or direct sowing, and also doing a lot of turning over beds. As you can kind of see in the background, we terminated this cover crop right here. There's a lot of cover crop from over the winter that the next few weeks we're going to be working on. Terminating it and using it as mulch to plant directly into. You can also see our great hardworking crew. We'll have them say hello, but they are just crushing. Turning over beds. It's sort of a big process of taking out any weeds or plants that are dead or no longer viable. Then we broad fork. We might add amendments. We generally harrow, which is a very It's a way to till the soil, but it goes horizontally and only goes a few inches deep. It kind of aerates the soil, and then we plant. So it's a big process. We have a good crew today. Most of our folks are here for the season. They can give a wave if they want. Busy. We're always busy.
Right now.
Just another plug too, this is a lot of our consistent staff, but we are still looking for volunteers. Our first Volunteer Friday is in 2 weeks, April 2nd, and we're also still looking for work share members, so folks that commit to a 1 5-hour shift per week in exchange for a full CSA, so a full share of vegetables throughout the season. All right, so now we're sort of on the far side of the field behind the orchard. I was gonna talk a little bit just about the different plants we have and vegetables and sort of their different life cycles. So some of the things we direct sow, and maybe it takes a month, like salad, to come up out of the ground and be ready to harvest. And then, you know, we normally cut most of our salads twice, so it might be in the ground for about 2 months. And other things like our garlic can be in the ground for like 7 to 8 months. So you can see it in the background. We planted the garlic at the end of October, like right around Halloween, and it's gonna be in this part of the field until about July when we harvest it. Another more long time crop are carrots. So their days to maturity are normally around 70 to 80 days. This whole block used to be carrots. Some of the carrots that we've been selling over the winter that have that nice sugary crunch. And the carrots that are left, we planted at the very end of fall in hopes of overwintering them, and then kind of getting another head start of carrots in supply in the spring. Behind us, we just planted a bunch of our brassicas, a lot of the head cabbages, broccoli, napa. So hopefully those will be ready in May, mid-May, right when our CSA starts. So that's something to look forward to. And we also direct sowed some different mixes, baby curly kale and arugula, and you can see that that's just starting to pop up. And then another part of our sort of crop rotation, you know, we rotate crops so that the same family of plants isn't directly planted right after each other. The chickens here, it's pretty cool. Andy from Pinwheel Farms has been rotating. This isn't his entire flock, but it's a small portion of his flock. They've been helping us cut down this cover crop. You can sort of see that area they haven't ate. That's what this used to be. And they're helping us fertilize and sort of take down that cover crop, and we're gonna prep these beds shortly to plant our onions. And on the far side, the chickens were in that area and did a similar thing to the crops that were there, and we just planted potatoes there 2 days ago. So one of our goals here is to be a place where folks in the community can purchase all their vegetables, or at least a majority of them, that are, you know, grow in a safe and thoughtful way. Soon we're going to be having consistent Saturday markets in April. So every Saturday in April from 9 to 12, we're going to have a stand outside under the pavilion. And then when our CSA program starts in May, mid-May, we'll have two stands Wednesday and Saturday. So plenty of time to swing by and pick up any of the vegetables you need. We also coordinate with other farms in the area so that you have options to get milk or eggs or some meat as well. All this information is provided on our website. You can also sign up for our newsletter. It's a really great way to stay connected. We send out updates every week. Part of the updates are just a reminder about, you know, where to find us, but it also gives a specific availability of what sort of produce you can expect to see at the market. It, you know, gives a ton of other announcements and also kind of just updates you on what's going on in the field each week. So yeah, sign up. We'll see you soon.